Robots aren't just movie props anymore. They're in our kitchens, hospitals, warehouses, and even classrooms quietly doing the stuff we don't have time or patience for. You've probably seen a robot vacuum roll past your couch or a delivery bot cruising down the sidewalk like it's on the place. Yeah, that's not sci-fi. That's Tuesday. The smallest stuff came first. Vacuums, mops, and lawn bots that keep things tidy while we are at work. Then came the big moves, surgical robots making micro-precise cuts doctors couldn't do by hand, warehouse bots sorting packages faster than any human, and even robotic exoskeletons helping people walk again. Restaurants are trying them out too in China, Hong Kong. They're doing it. Robot chefs flipping burgers, coffee bots pouring lattes, and waiters that never mix up orders. In classrooms, kids are coding little robots to learn teamwork instead of just staring at the screens. Basically, the bots are creeping into every corner of our routines, and most of the time we don't even notice. The next big thing isn't robot taking over. It's robot teaming up. The buzzword is cobots, short for collaborative robots. These guys work next to people, not instead of them. They handle the boring, repetitive stuff so humans can focus on bigger things and what actually needs a brain. Offices are getting in it too. Some companies have AI-powered bots doing data entry, scheduling meetings, or answering customer chats so the human can think about other stuff. And in elder care, social robots are keeping people company and even helping with therapy. Creepy? Maybe a little, but also kind of amazing. So there are different kinds of robots. Soft robots, like they think squishy, bendy machines that can pick strawberries or crawl through rubble after disasters. Then we got swarms. These are hundreds of tiny bots working together like ants fixing roads, cleaning oceans, or planting crops. Smarter brains. These are AIs making robots think on their feet. No more pre-programmed moves. They adapt, learn, and improvise. Then we got these green robots. They are eco-friendly materials, solar power, and recycling tech that are shaping our future, a sustainable future. And we got emotional bots. Yeah, it sounds wild, but engineers are trying to give robots a kind of emotional IQ so they get us better without being too uncanny. The bottom line is, robots aren't here to steal our jobs or our souls. They're here because we built them to make life easier, and they're only getting smarter, smoother, and more human-friendly. The real question isn't if they be everywhere, it's how we'll live with them once they are. I wrote a book called Robotics, the Invisible Revolution that reveals how machines are quietly rewriting the rules of modern civilization. What does my book cover? The mechanics of robots, how they are built, how they work, how we can create robots according to our own needs, their history, today's leading technologies, and my insights in future of robotics and the ethical questions shaping our future with AI, especially AI robots. So venture into the cutting-edge humanoid companions, sworn robotics, AI integrated machines, and the future of autonomous systems. This is your guide to understanding the invisible forces redefining our world while reflecting on the ethical and societal responsibilities of a robot-driven future. Get your copy. Until next time, have a good one.